Oh, what?
It's Red.
Hey! What the hell?
Welcome to Lazyboys Night. That's Dude.
And this is Dude.
And tonight we are drinking the Nickel Brook? We should really look at the labels first. I'm going to say that.
Blackberry Jam Stan Real Fruit Berliner Weiss. What? That's a long title.
So it's the Nickel Brook Brewery, and it's the Blackberry Jam Stand, and the subtitle says Real Fruit Berliner Weiss. It's a German style beer made with blackberry. Ooh, it's a sour beer.
Look at the color of that.
It's
almost like blood orange, but it's
cool.
Okay, so that's what we're drinking tonight, and on tonight's episode also,
the Crappy Bowl of Mystery.
It's just two guys talking. There they go again, saying anything. Talking about nothing. Nothing new to say, talking anyway. So much to review. So let's have a cold brew.
A cold brew.
Everybody's talking. It's not anything.
It's very sour.
Oh, I don't like that face.
It's good.
Not that I don't like your face in general.
No, you don't like my face.
That's true. I don't like
your face either.
I have problems looking at it. That's why I have to.
Look at me. It's good, but it's. I was not expecting a sour.
Let me go through this moment.
Sour. If you're into sour beers, it's actually quite good. It's quite sour.
I don't appreciate sour beers, but I will admit, as a non-appreciator of such beers, this one's actually pretty good.
Yeah,
another beer that I like. What?
I think my taste buds were like, what's going on? Now they're I expect it.
The day that there's a beer that I really don't like, I'm probably not going to want to say, well, are we still going to say who makes it? Because if I like almost everything,
we'll edit it out
which brewery. But no, for sour, damn, this is pretty good.
It's like you'll see the second sip is not nearly as bad because now you know what to expect.
But yeah,
that's good.
That's it's sour. Nice, very nice. Beer.
All right,
good. Actually, the color's kind of cool too.
All right, so as we promised, the Crappy Bowl of Mystery.
All right.
I don't know if
you can
see.
So how does this work?
But there's actually a little what do you call those? When they print labels? It's a label thing.
It's a printed label. Why is that so difficult?
It says the Crappy Bowl of Mystery.
Okay. All right. So I'm picking this at it. You're putting it towards me, so I guess I'm the one.
Pressure's on you.
So we're clear.
If it's a crappy question, it's your fault.
The Crappy Bowl of Mystery, man. We have no idea what we're going to be picking out of here. So. All right, we got one.
All right.
Let's find out. Oh, this is a super serious one. Oh,
man.
Yeah, we don't need to make it serious, though, but it's a serious question.
Okay.
All right. You ready?
Uh-huh.
Why is it so difficult to be nice and not selfish?
What is this, philosophy class?
No, this is from Steven from New York.
Thank you, Stephen from New York.
Stephen, what's going on in your life, man?
Are you selfish, Stephen?
No,
or
he's not.
Nice?
He's asking why it's so difficult. Oh,
yeah.
I guess it could be. Why is it so difficult for him?
He's trying to be nice, but apparently
Stephen, what's going
to be selfish.
On? Seriously, man.
So have you made selfish choices recently,
Are you
Stephen?
Feeling remorse or something? Are you like, because that's what's building up inside. Apparently.
Are you afraid Santa is watching, Stephen? Is that it? You want to be nice?
How old are you, Stephen? If you're 7, we got a different answer than if you're 27.
All right. So why is it so difficult to be nice?
And not selfish.
And not selfish.
So I guess the question
Well, Lizen. We know what the question is.
No, we're not. Okay, the breakdown of the question. I need another drink.
Yeah.
Continue.
Well, okay. So it's really about, do you focus on your needs first, which is the selfish part, or do you consider others, which is the nice part?
But that apparently is very difficult to do.
Apparently for some people. I think it depends on who you are. I've known people who don't even understand how people can be selfish. They're so giving. They're so nice. You love these people. You meet them, oh, they're so nice. And they could never, ever be selfish. And then on the other extreme, there's those people who've never...
Don't even know that they're being selfish.
Yeah, oh yeah, they're so selfish. They just think this is how people are, and they can't conceive of anyone actually being nice for nice sake. And I think most of us are in the middle. But the question is not where do you stand. The question is, why is it so hard to be nice?
Why is it so hard to be nice?
Well, it's not hard to be nice to people who are nice.
Well, exactly. You don't know who you're going to be nice to. So, example, if you're walking by and I hold the door open for you, you walk by, don't even acknowledge my existence, and just walk right through without saying thank you or anything like that. Maybe that's a Canadian thing to say thank you all the time.
I would never not say thank you.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
I'm sorry. but yeah, that if that happens enough to you, that you let somebody go in front of you, and there's not the hand wave, or, you know, you're going in whatever circumstance where you're in line and you see somebody with two products, but you got a whole cart of food and you let them go ahead of you, but they don't even say anything. And you get to a point where you're going, you know what? F it. I'm tired of being nice because nobody else is nice to me.
You said something that triggered something in me. Have you ever heard of the grocery cart test? I was itchy and thinking.
No, I have not.
Apparently, when I think, I get itchy. You've never heard the grocery cart test? Okay, you know how when you go...
I love how I gave that an example, and right away you could pull out something that comes from
well,
whatever.
It's, you inspired me.
That's why there's two of us.
You know how when you go to the grocery store and you're done and you take the cart back with all your groceries, you get in your car, boom. The little rally area where you can push the carts back is not that far. Now, if you don't push the cart back, you're not hurting anybody.
Okay, correct.
There's technically someone employed by the grocery store to pick up these carts and push them back.
Yes.
You have no obligation to push the cart back.
Okay, continue.
To do so is purely to be nice and avoid trouble for people trying to park.
Just to leave your cart in the parking lot.
Yeah, because leaving your cart in the parking lot is selfish. I don't want to have to walk 50 feet to push it away.
That's a jerk move, by the way.
Yeah, but...
I think it's a jerk
move. I agree. It's a selfish move. It's like, I don't have to walk 50 feet that way. Nobody knows me. Nobody's policing me. Nobody cares. It's not a crime. But the nice person will push it anyways. Why? Because they don't want to block parking spots. And they don't want that poor schlep who's just spending all day rallying up the carts have to do extra work.
So what's the point of this?
The point is, that's the test to see who is nice and who is selfish.
So
this is a legitimate test.
They've done this like in a legit parking lot.
It's a philosophical. It's a philosophical question.
So like the tree that falls in a forest.
Yes, but you could actually test it if you want. You could watch who's pushing the cart back and who's not, and say, "There's a nice person." Why? Because there's no reason for them to actually do it other than to just be nice.
And you know what I've observed, if we're going to continue talking about carts, is that usually if there's a single cart left in the parking lot or on the sidewalk, other people will also leave it on the sidewalk. But if you go and all the carts are put away where they're supposed to be, usually there's not other carts around.
Yeah, you lead by example.
So it takes that one jerk to set off a jerk chain reaction.
This is true, but we still haven't answered the question, why is it so much harder to be nice?
Because being a jerk is super easy.
Yeah.
I could easily be a jerk.
Yes,
that would be easy.
Yes, he could.
But this is much more difficult.
This is a little creepy, actually.
A little pat on the back.
You made me feel uncomfortable.
Good job.
He touched me in my special place.
No, it's
not. No, okay.
but definitely. So, being the good guy... Or the good girl, or...
Being selfish is easier.
Being a good person is way more difficult because you don't often get that returned.
Yeah,
While being a jerk, a lot of people are jerks, so you just fall into the jerk category.
And being nice requires you to be conscientious of others. Whereas being selfish, all you got to think about is yourself.
Yeah, so that's super easy.
So it's effort. It's effort to be nice. But a truly nice person, it's not effort for them because that's their default setting.
That's exactly. And that's the point of being nice, is that you're not being selfish. You're thinking about others. And you realize that whatever you do will impact somebody else or other people, and you're conscious of it, and you will make those decisions based on that. But somebody who's doesn't push the cart back, or whatever it may be, or doesn't say thank you or please, or doesn't recognize the fact that somebody's doing something nice for them,
then you slash your tires. No, don't.
No, he did not just
no, say that. Because that is not nice.
That's not nice.
That is selfish. There you go. So who's the nicest person you know?
The nicest person I know, don't even, yeah. the nicest person, that's a big question.
Oh, that's not the question, though.
No, that's your question.
I know.
It's a question.
It is, and you're right. Okay, answer.
Why would you put me on a spot like that? I know a lot of people.
Because there's a camera, and that's the whole point of this show.
Do you have, off the top of your head, the nicest person you've ever known?
Nicest person ever in my entire existence? Or the nicest person I currently frequent?
It's up to you, man. It's your freaking question.
All right.
You decide.
I'm going to say, I don't know. There's a lot of nice
guys.
You know what?
You know what? You're
nice.
I bet you most people would say their mom or their grandmother. That would be the go-to, the easy answer.
Yeah, that's too easy to answer.
That's what I mean. That's too easy.
That's just too easy.
That's copping out. That's being selfish.
Yeah. Oh, well played, sir. Anyways, yeah.
So
Steven,
what's the actual answer for Steven in New York? I don't know if you're going through stuff because of what we're going through in the entire world right now.
Make the effort to think of other Steven.
But the thing is you're not looking for payback. I think that's the whole point of being nice, is that you're not looking for payback. You're just, because as a human being, we want to be able to evolve properly and just be nice to each other. And it's... if everybody makes that little effort to be nice to each other, then it will pay back. And then most people will want to be nice. I'm sorry.
That was beautiful.
Yeah,
I know. That was beautiful.
I was just being nice.
Oh. So was I. It wasn't that good a speech.
You're not that good of an actor either. Okay, so.
Oh.
That wasn't being nice. No.
No. Hey, I have IMDb credits. Anyways, be nice, Steven. That's the point.
Be nice. And it's a lot easier to be a jerk. Don't go the easy route. Cheers.